Thank you, Mrs. Florrick. And what is your current living situation?
I live with our two children in a three-bedroom apartment at 3001 North Dearborn Street.
And is there room for Mr. Florrick there?
Yes.
And should he be granted a pretrial release, are you prepared to have him at home? Do you want him there?
I think Peter should be home with his children.
Thank you.
Mrs. Florrick, you mentioned the apartment is a three-bedroom and you have two children. Would they share a room?
No.
So, you and your husband would share a room?
Yes.
You're saying under oath that you intend to share a bed with a man.
Objection, Your Honor. Relevance.
I'm simply establishing that there truly is a place for Mr. Florrick
this
and everything that's...
private family matter, Your Honor.
That's enough, Counselor. Whether they intend to share a bed is of no concern to this court.
Thank you, Your Honor. Mrs. Florrick, I have one more question. Did you meet with a divorce attorney on February 23rd?
Yes. I had a brief consultation with a divorce attorney a few days after the allegations against my husband surfaced in order to weigh my options.
Are you saying you've ruled out the possibility of divorce?
I have no plans to divorce.
But you haven't ruled it out.
I haven't ruled out running for president. Probably won't happen, but I haven't ruled it out.
So you intend to welcome Mr. Florrick back into your home?
Yes.
Despite the sexual dalliances with call girls...
My son is here, Mr. Landry.
Are you suggesting you'd give different answers if he weren't?
I'm suggesting you stop asking invasive and irrelevant questions.
Isn't it true?
What's your goal here, Mr. Landry?
Mrs. Florrick.
To do your boss's bidding? To embarrass me? Embarrass my husband? To goad me into some emotional public renunciation of him? The relevant question here is whether Peter has a suitable place to go home to. And I am stating under oath that he does. Any further questions?
Why don't we leave it there? I'll take the arguments and testimony into consideration and rule tomorrow.